हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर ओपी तिवारी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज श्रीगंगानगर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस जॉर्ज इलियट्स आर्ट ऑफ प्लॉट कंस्ट्रक्शन। एज यू नो, हर प्लॉट्स आर क्वाइट ओरिजिनल एंड नॉन कन्वेंशनल। द ट्रेडिशनल इंग्लिश नावल कंसिस्टेड ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स एंड इंसिडेंट्स नीट टूगेदर by an intrigue centering around a young attractive hero and heroine and rounded off with their happy marriage. The plot did not, except in the single case of Vanity Fair, arise from the characters. It was imposed by the author on them. The plots of the novels of Henry Fielding, Charles Dickens, William Thackeray, Mrs. Gaskell, etc., are traditional in this sense. But George Eliot showed originality in the art of plot construction. She began with an idea of character or situation. Her plot did not necessarily entail a marriage or a happy ending. In her novel, Silas Mariner, the hero is an elderly heroine. The Mill on the Floss ends very badly and has no hero at all. In Middlemarch, there is no central figure of any kind. So the plots of George Eliot's novels are not built on a standardized formula. They follow a logical development of idea. They have no central figures of the traditional type and few strokes of fortunes, coincidences and sudden inheritances. The plots of George Eliot are based on logical causation, that is logical development of idea. She connects events and characters with each other very logically. The end is implicit in the beginning. Successive events are logically and causally connected with each other, and as the action proceeds, it is seen to be the logical and natural outcome of the characters or characters concerned, and those characters themselves are the result of their social environment. Thus, the final catastrophe in The Mill on the Floss follows logically from Maggie's love of her brother and her emotional, noble and self-effacing nature. Her death by drowning is hinted at right from the beginning, when her mother repeatedly calls her a wild thing and is afraid that she would be drowned one day. George Eliot shares the awareness of modern man that human society is constantly changing and developing. Consequently, the organic form of her novels, an inner circle, a small group of individuals involved in a moral dilemma, surrounded by an outer circle, that is the social world within which the dilemma has to be resolved, is more significant than in any preceding fiction. Furthermore, her perception of individual human beings is more complex than that of her predecessors. She never suggests a simple division of characters into good and bad. The individual, like the environment, has evolved and is evolving, and the action is designed to show this evolution. This is what George Eliot meant when she said, "My stories grow in me like plants." It is the growth of the plant, the gradual unfolding of character in its environment, that compels attention, not the mere events, as is the case with the novelist in the Fielding tradition. George Eliot's novels are organic wholes. The characters, the setting, the social environment are well integrated. They show unity of action. She strives after a full vision of life. In all her novels, there is an interpenetration between the life of a community and the individual lives that and the individual lives that compose it. Her novels are compact wholes. They have a beginning, a middle, and an end. The novels of George Eliot are primarily an entertainment, and George Eliot's novels are not deficient in this respect. Curiosity is excited from the very beginning. The readers are eager to know what will happen next, what will be the next step, and are fully involved in the fate of the central figure or figures. And as the action proceeds, we get an analysis, a presentation of the inner drama, the moral conflict which goes on within the mind of the central figures. In this way, her novels acquire a gripping interest. The melodramatic is also introduced in deference to prevalent conventions. That means there is the element of melodrama in her novels. Her delicious humor and excellently done scenes of pathos also contribute to the charm and fascination of her stories. But it is the inner man, the conflict within the soul, which increasingly absorbs the attention, so that the reader does not like to put down the book unfinished. Thank you.